This is Teresa Adams, and what we're going to be doing today is we're going to be graphing a polynomial function. So we have f of x is equal to x minus 1 multiplied by x minus 2 multiplied by x plus 4. The first thing we want to do when we're looking at our polynomial function is we want to know what the end behavior is. In other words, as we approach negative infinity, what's happening to the graph? As we approach positive infinity, what's happening to our graph? The way in which we figured out our end behavior is we need to know what our degree is. Now, I can multiply all this out, but I don't really want to. If I were to multiply all this out, I would know that in the first one I'd have an x term. The second factor I'd have an x term. And the third factor I'd have an x term. And if I were to multiply it all out, I'd have x to the 3. I don't want to multiply it all out. I just want to know that in this one I'll get an x term. If I multiply these two together, I get another x term. And I multiply by this one, I get another x term, so I have an x to the 3. So my degree of my polynomial is 3. We also call the degree n when we're talking about polynomials. So it's degree 3 or n equals 3. The next thing I need to know about my end behavior is I've got to figure out what my leading coefficient is. So I'm just going to pull off the coefficients off my x terms. Right out front here, I have a 1. It's an implied 1, so I have 1 to start out with. The coefficient on this term is a 1. The coefficient on this term is a 1. And the coefficient on this term is a 1. So I have 1 as my leading coefficient, or my an. So an is 1, which is greater than 0. Based on my degree and my leading coefficient, my end behavior as I approach negative infinity and positive infinity will look like this. As I approach negative infinity, I get a negative infinity. As I approach positive infinity, I get a positive infinity. The next thing I'm going to do after I figure out what my end behavior is figure out what the max number of turns is. To figure out the max number of turns, is you just take your degree and subtract 1 from it. So n minus 1, for us, is going to be 3 minus 1, which is 2. I have at most 2 turns. I'm not guaranteed 2 turns, but I have at most 2 turns. If I have a graph that has more than 2 turns, then I made a mistake, either at my degree here, or I made a mistake here, one of the two. The next thing I'm going to do after I find my end behavior and my max number of turns is I'm going to find out what my y-intercepts are. My y-intercepts, what I do is I put in 0 for x, so f of 0 is equal to. I put in 0 for x, and I'm going to have 0 minus 1 multiplied by 0 minus 2 multiplied by 0 plus 4. So I end up with a negative 1, negative 2, and 4. Negative 1 multiplied by negative 2 is a positive 2 times 4 is 8. So my y-intercept happens at 0, 8. Okay, step number 4 is we're going to find our x-intercepts, or the zeros of the polynomial. To find our x-intercepts, or the zero of the polynomial, is we take each one of our factors and set them to 0. So we have x minus 1 is equal to 0, x minus 2 is equal to 0, and x plus 4 is equal to 0. This gives me x is equal to 1, x is equal to 2, and x is equal to negative 4. These are the places in which I'm going to hit the x-axis. So I'm going to hit the x-axis at 1, 0, 2, 0, and negative 4, 0. These are my intercepts, or the zeros of the polynomial. At those zeros, I need to figure out what's happening. So that's step number 5. But before I get to step number 5, I'm going to look at the multiplicity of each zero. When I'm talking about the multiplicity of each zero, I'm talking about the degree right there. In that case, if there's not anything there, it's a degree 1. If the multiplicity is a degree that is odd, then I'm going to go to those zeros and I'm going to pass through them. So in this case, because it's a multiplicity of 1, that's odd, I'm going to pass through them. All of these, in fact, have multiplicities of 1, and all of those, I'm going to pass through those. Had this been 2, 4, 6, or 8, as the degrees of each one of these, then I would have bounced at those. But for this example, I'm going to go to each one of those zeros, and I'm going to pass through them. To find the behavior in which the graph is as I approach those zeros, I'm going to put in x is equal to 1 into my original polynomial, with the exception of the factor that's going to produce a 0. So if I put in x is equal to 1 in my very first factor, then that would produce a 0, and that's not helpful. So on that very first one, because if I put in x equals 1 right there, I'm going to get a 0, I'm going to leave it as x, and I won't do the replacement there. But I will put 1 in for the next one and the next one. So I have 1 minus 2 multiplied by 1 plus 4. This gives me a negative 1. This gives me 5. So I have negative 5x minus 1. So what I have is I have a linear function here that has a slope of negative 5. So very quickly, I know it's going to have something that looks like that. I have a slope that's going to be negative, and it's going to be decreasing from left to right. When x equals 2, I have f of 2 is equal to, and now I'm going to put that 2 into that very first term, or the very first factor, because if I put 2 in the very first factor, I don't have any problems there. So I have 2 minus 1 times, but I do have a problem there, so I leave that as x minus 2, multiplied by, and then I have 2 plus 4. I get 1 here, I get 6 here, so I have 6, x minus 2. So once again, I have a linear function. This time my slope is positive, and so it's going to look something like this. I do my last one, which is x minus 4. F of x minus 4 is equal to negative 4 minus 1, negative 4 minus 2, and lastly, x plus 4. Because again, if I put negative 4 in there, I'd get 0, and that would not be helpful. So what I've got is negative 5, negative 1 minus 1 more is negative 5, times a negative 6, so that gives me a positive 30, x plus 4. Steps 1 through 5 to graph it. The first thing I have to do is draw my graph. Based on the fact from step number 1, I know that my end behavior on this will be positive infinity as I go to positive infinity, and negative infinity when I go into negative infinity. So it's a down-up type situation. Based on step number 2, I'm going to have at most 2 turns. I can't have more than 2 turns, but I may only have 1 turn. I won't know until I start graphing this. Step number 3 tells me that I have a y-intercept at 8. So right there is my y-intercept. Step number 4 tells me I have x-intercepts at negative 4, at 1, and at 2. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to graph it. I'm going to let this very bottom left corner. Then I'm going to start here. I'm going to go to my first 0, which is negative 4. Based on step 4 and 5, I know I'm going to touch that, and I'm going to pass through it. I need to come back up here to 8, because I know I have to go through that 0, because it's on my y-intercept. I have to go through it. And then I'm going to come down to my next 0, which happens to be 1, at 1. Again, based on steps 4 and 5, I pass through it. I come back up into my next 0, which is at 2. Based on steps 4 and 5, I pass through it. And there is my graph.